Since the days when Mexico was a significant competitor to Hollywood in terms of film output and quality, the United States' closest Latin neighbor has produced the majority of Latin America's top-selling vocalists. The imagery of the charro or cowboy easily transitioned into the contemporary day crooner in a way that millions of people have found appealing. Welcome back to our channel, ladies and gentlemen, where today we have made a list of the top 10 Mexican singers, in no particular order, who also happen to be the most popular in Latin America. Welcome to Top Everything, where you get top 10 videos on anything and everything, and if you like such content, then make sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit that bell icon. Now let's start with number 10, Vincent Fernandez. Vincent Chente Fernandez Gomez, a Mexican retired singer, actor, and film producer, was born on February 17, 1940. Fernandez is known as El Ídolo de México, which translates to the Idol of Mexico. He began his career as a busker and has since gone on to release more than 50 albums and appear in more than 30 films. Rancheras and other Mexican favorites are among his repertoire. He is accompanied by a mariachi band in person, but he is not a mariachi artist because he only sings live. After the death of Javier Solís, Vicente's fame grew. 3 Grammy Awards, 8 Latin Grammy Awards, 14 Lo Nuestro Awards, and a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame have all been bestowed upon Fernandez for his work. He is one of the best-selling regional Mexican artists of all time, with over 50 million records sold globally. Number 9. Juan Gabriel. Juan Gabriel, also known as Juanga and El Divo de Juárez, was noted for his flamboyant flair, which broke down limits in the Latin music industry. He has been dubbed a pop icon and is widely regarded as one of the best and most prolific Mexican composers and vocalists of all time. Juan Gabriel was one of Latin America's best-selling singer-songwriters, with an estimated 60 million records sold worldwide. Recuerdos Volume 2, his 19th studio album, is said to be Mexico's best-selling album of all time, with over 8 million copies sold. Juan Gabriel composed around 1,800 songs during the course of his career. With a resume as solid as that, it goes without saying he makes it to the top 10 Mexican artists of all time. Number 8. Pedro Infante Cruz. Pedro Infante Cruz was a well-known Mexican actor and ranchera singer whose career spanned 2 decades, and whose renown and popularity spread throughout Latin America, including Venezuela, Colombia, Guatemala, and Peru, after appearing in a number of films during Mexico's Golden Age. His cinematic career began in 1939, with him acting in over 60 films, 30 of which he co-starred in with his brother, Angel Infante. He also recorded over 350 songs beginning in 1943. He won the Silver Bear for Best Actor at the 7th Berlin International Film Festival for his performance in the film Tizoc. Unfortunately, he died in a plane crash near Yucatan on April 15, 1957, while en route to Mexico City after an engine failed on takeoff. A gold bracelet discovered afterwards helped to identify his remains. Number 7. Antonio Aguilera. Antonio Aguilera, a Mexican singer, actor, songwriter, equestrian, film producer, and screenwriter, was born in Mexico City. Standing at 6'1", his name in the music industry was as big as his height. He made over 150 albums, selling over 25 million copies, and appeared in over 120 films. Because he is credited with popularizing the Mexican equestrian sport La Charrera to worldwide audiences, he was given the honorific nickname El Charro de México, or Mexico's horseman, due to his equestrian background. In 1950, Aguilera began his singing career on the Mexican radio station XEW. In the same year, he secured a deal with Mozart Records and became one of its best-selling musicians. In the drama Un Rincón Cerca del Cielo, he made his acting debut alongside Pedro Infante, and from there, it was all blue skies for him. Number 6. Jorge Negrete. After being enrolled in the military by his father, Negrete developed a keen interest in music. In 1931, he began his career singing operatic roles on the radio in Mexico City. In 1936, he acquired a contract with NBC Television to host a television show. He returned to Mexico in 1937 to star in the film La Madrina del Diablo, and because of the picture's success, he was able to secure numerous more contracts over the next 3 years. In 1938, he co-starred with Elisa Christi in La Valentina, and later in Untos Pero No Revoltos. Negrete was signed to act in Ay Jalisco, No Teres, which made him an international Latin sensation and helped to establish the charro cinema genre. During production, he met Gloria Marn, which led to their romance and a series of films together. Recognize these singers? If you do, then make sure to like the video, subscribe to Top Everything, and hit that bell icon to never miss an update. Number 5. Javier Solis. Javier Solis began singing in competitions under the alias Javier Lucan, with the winner receiving a new pair of shoes, from which he was later barred from participating due to his dominance of the competition. He was working as a butcher at the time, and singing while doing so. His supervisor, David Larraos, overheard him and was so amazed by his skill that he encouraged Solis to devote himself to music and recommended a vocal coach, even paying for his singing lessons. When Solis began performing in the United States, Central America, and South America in 1957, he gained international renown. He was one of the first artists to perform in the new bolero ranchero style. He performed boleros, which are usually associated with trio music, but are now accompanied by mariachis. Solis was a talented interpreter who sang rancheras, corridos, danzones, waltzes, and tangos in addition to boleros. Number 4. José José. José Romulo Sola Ortiz, professionally known as José José, was a Mexican musician, singer, and actor. José began his musical career in his early teens, playing guitar and singing in serenade, as he was born into a family of musicians. Later, he sang and played bass and double bass in a jazz and bossa nova combo. José rose to international notoriety in the 1980s after signing with Ariola Records as one of the most popular and brilliant Latin performers. His album Secretos, released in 1983, has sold over 4 million copies. He was nominated for multiple Grammy Awards and garnered widespread acclaim for his many international songs. His music was heard in areas where Spanish was not spoken, such as Japan, Israel, and Russia. He made a name for himself as an actor, starring in films like Galavan o Palom. Number 3. Armando Manzanero. Armando Manzanero Canché was a Mayan musician, singer, composer, actor, and music producer from Mexico. He is largely regarded as the finest Mexican romantic composer of the post-war era, as well as one of Latin America's most successful composers. In 2014, he was honored with a Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award in the United States. He was also the president of Mexico's Authors and Composers Society. In 1959, an RCA Victor official encouraged him to make his debut album of love songs, which he dubbed Mi Primera Grabación, or My First Record. With the song Cuando Estoy Contigo, he received first place at the Festival de la Canción in Miami in 1965. With the song Señor Amor, he earned first place at the Mallorca Festival in Spain in 1978. The Yamaha Festival awarded the song Corazón Amigo in 1982. In 1993, Billboard Magazine honored him for his outstanding musical career. Number 2. El Chelino Sanchez. Chelino was one of the first and most well-known narco corrido singers. He wrote stories that reflected his Sinaloa upbringing and experiences. Despite the fact that he rarely discussed the drug trade directly in his music, audiences understood the connection and connotation. Chelino highlighted the stories of valientes who overcame unfathomable poverty to survive and rise to power, as well as the realities of dying in a corrupt system of violence. Chelino was assassinated in 1992 after a group of armed men pulled him over at a traffic roundabout and presented state police identification cards. Chelino was blindfolded, bound, and shot twice in the head. Though there is little likelihood the murder was motivated by the drug trade, no motive has been found and no suspects have been detained. His renown and recordings have risen in popularity since his death. Nearly 3 decades after his death, Chelino still has millions of streams and is still very popular among young Hispanic listeners. Number 1. José Alfredo Jiménez. Miguel Asiev's Meja and a group of pals went to a restaurant in Santa Maria de la Rivera called La Serena for dinner one night in 1948. "Don Miguel," said the clerk, approaching him, "because it's necessary, I work as a waiter, but I also write music. Is there anything you'd like to hear? They may appeal to you." José Alfredo Jiménez, the waiter's name. José Alfredo appeared on the radio a few days later and began singing his songs a cappella, including Ella and others. Ella, Yo, Serenada, Huastica, and Tu Recuerdo Yo were among the songs he recorded. The first recordings of José Alfredo Jiménez's songs. He composed around 1,000 songs after this promising start, and from then, it was all upwards. Did you enjoy this video? Let us know in the comments, and while you are there, also like this video and subscribe to Top Everything, and hit that bell button as well. Thank you, take care, and goodbye.